Namaste. Hello, everyone. Myself, Rohini Merugu, talking about spherical coordinate system, learning outcomes. At the end of this video, you will be able to define the volume element in spherical coordinate system. You will be able to write the equations for differential length, surface area, and volume in spherical coordinate system. You will be able to figure out the minimum and maximum ranges for different coordinate axes. Learning outcomes we have seen. Now let us go for the next part. List the coordinates in Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system. I have already uploaded the videos on Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system. Just revise and list the coordinates in Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system. So the coordinates in Cartesian coordinate system are x, y, z, and the coordinates in cylindrical coordinate system are rho, phi, z. So today in this video we are going to see the spherical coordinate system, which has coordinates r, theta, phi. So the spherical coordinate system consists of one circle, one plane, and one cone. One circle is r constant circle, that is shown here, the circle. One plane, which is phi constant plane, the one which is shown in yellow color, that is phi constant plane. A cone, one cone, which is theta constant cone, shown in violet color, we can see here. So this is one circle, one plane, and a cone together forms the spherical coordinate system having the coordinates r, theta, phi. You can see here the center one, the circle size is moving from 0 and it is increasing, it can go to maximum value. This plane, which is shown in red color, is moving from 0 and moving in 360 degrees. We can see this cone is starting from 0, moving to 180 degrees, and also the same cone is repeating in downward direction. The same values are repeating of the theta in downward direction. Theta is always measured with respect to z axis. Let me show you in the further diagrams how I can locate a point r, theta, phi in spherical coordinate system. The point P is the intersection of all these three coordinates, like one circle, which is r constant circle. So we take r constant or a constant, here it is shown. Then we have to take the theta constant cone. This is theta constant cone plane, I can see here. Then phi constant plane, this is a phi constant plane, I can see here. So intersection of these three will give me the point P, which is r, theta, phi. If I want to draw it simply like this, I can draw a small section of a sphere, and I can take the angle theta phi with respect to x-axis. If this is the angle phi, I can consider the angle theta, which is with respect to z-axis. This is the angle theta, this is the point P, and this is the radius r. So this way I can show point P. The differential lengths are, if this is dr, the small length is dr. If this is r, the small variation along that length is dr. If this is phi, the small variation along this is d phi. And if this is theta, the small variation in this direction is d theta. But whether can I say d theta and d phi as lengths? Yes, dr is a length, fine. But can I say d theta and d phi as a length? Surely we cannot. Theta and d phi are these are the angles and not the lengths. Then what are the lengths? Let us see this. So if I want to show you what is the length, if I want to find this length, the angle is d theta. To find this length, I should multiply it with this distance. So this distance is r and the angle is d theta. So it is coming to be r d theta, as you can see here, r d theta. If at all I want to find this distance, this one, so I can project it downward here, this one. So I need to find out this distance first. What is this? So this one is nothing but r sine theta. It is the front side for theta. So it is r sine theta. If the same is projected downward, it is r sine theta and this much angle d phi. So r sine theta d phi is nothing but this length. This is r sine theta d phi is this length. So the lengths in the spherical coordinate system are dr in the radial direction dr, in this direction it is r sin theta d phi, and you can see this one is along the cone variation is r d theta. These are the three lengths in differential lengths in spherical coordinate system. Three lengths along the three axis are dr, r d theta, r sin theta d phi. The length is a vector quantity, remember. So we can write it as a dl bar. Bar indicates a vector which is equal to dr ar bar plus r d theta a theta bar plus r sin theta d phi a phi bar. So this way I can write dl bar. So these are the lengths dr, r d theta and r sin theta d phi. We can also write the surfaces, differential surface or area, which is multiplication of two lengths. So surface or area is nothing but a vector quantity which two lengths I should multiply. So if I write the surface ds1, if I multiply dr and r d theta, the leftover is a phi. So I can write unit vector as a phi, and the opposite direct side will be with minus a phi. When I multiply the two lengths as r d theta and r sin theta d phi, I'll get r square sin theta d theta d phi. As dr is not there, the unit vector comes as ar. The opposite side of the same surface is minus ar. Again here we can see, if I multiply this dr and r sin theta d phi, I get r sin theta dr d phi and a theta bar, and the opposite side of the opposite surface will be with minus a theta. This way I can write differential surfaces in spherical coordinate system. Differential volume. Volume is nothing but multiplication of three lengths dr, r d theta, r sin theta d phi. Volume is nothing but a scalar quantity. So dv can be written as dr, r d theta, r sin theta d phi. It's multiplication. So I get dv as r square sin theta dr d theta d phi. This is the differential volume. Now, I can write the range also. You can see the sphere which is changing its radius from 0, and it can go to the maximum value, that is infinity. So r is ranging from 0 to infinity. Phi is same like in a cylindrical coordinate system. It is ranging from 0 and it is moving the complete circle, that is 360 degrees. So its range of phi is 0 to 2 pi. But remember, the middle coordinate in spherical coordinate system is theta and not phi. So theta is forming a cone which is with respect to z-axis. If I measure, its angle is 0 to 180 degrees. As it is measured with respect to z-axis, it's you can see here, it's 0 to 180 degrees. So likewise, theta is 0 to pi. So r is ranging from 0 to infinity, theta is 0 to pi, and phi is 0 to 2 pi. Now, can we think about what angles I have shown here, which is showing me phi constant plane and which is showing me theta constant plane? So to understand it, I have shown the watermelon slices and lemon slices. The way we cut the watermelon and put the slices, these slices are showing me phi constant plane. For this piece, there is some constant value of phi. For this piece, there is another constant value of phi. That means when I'm moving the knife, my knife is nothing but some phi constant plane which is moving along. So this particular slice is having phi constant. Now when I cut the lemon, and when I'm cutting the lemon with the knife, my knife is showing me the theta constant plane. For this lemon, when I connect it to the origin or to the center point, it will be forming, giving me some angle theta. This lemon slice will give different value of theta. This lemon slice will give me different value of theta. So these are lemon slices are theta constant planes. Unit vectors, of course, dot product is easy to find. AR dot AR bar is 1. If A theta dot A theta bar is 1. A phi bar dot A phi bar is equal to 1. But to find the cross product, I should follow this triangle, the arrows like this. Like AR cross A theta is A phi, the third unit vector. I'm moving in the same direction of the arrow. If I'm moving in the opposite direction of the arrow, like A theta cross AR is minus A phi. Similarly, A theta cross A phi is AR, and A phi cross A theta is minus AR. And A phi cross AR, same direction of the arrow, is A theta, and AR cross A phi is minus of a theta. This way I can find the cross product of the unit vectors. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.